Hello and welcome to the show. Today you're about to discover an organization that seems to have the perfect balance between its not-for-profit work and its for-profit work. It's been enabling businesses through technology and sustainably so for about a decade now. This is Mahiti.
Mahiti Infotech is a Bangalore-based firm delivering cutting-edge technology to for-profit and not-for-profit organizations. Much of its own profits go towards subsidizing services for not-for-profits. Mahiti's CEO, Srikanth, talks to me about their priorities: technology enablement, building capacity through technology, and active contribution to the free and open source movement.
You seem to have an interesting business model. Can you tell me a bit more about it?
The idea was that Mahiti wants to do work that has a greater, that does greater social good. But we did not want to go down the way of raising grants, because the grantees will have their own expectation on how the money has to be spent. And sometimes there is a gap in the way they understand the sector. And only way we could do was to do some amount of quality commercial work, which gets us market revenues, and then use part of that money to subsidize our work and part of that and remaining money to enhance the institutional growth. Lot of work that we do for for-profit clients is cutting edge, sometimes even bleeding edge. The experience that we gain from doing cutting edge work, we can take back to the non-profit work. Sometimes non-profit work also allows us to do work that is unparalleled by the commercial work.
And that's amazing, because, you know, the non-profits would get as much, you know, let's say a portion or slice of your know-how as the for-profits would. So how important do you think technology is in helping non-profits be more impactful?
The only way to enhance the impact of their work is to embrace technology, because moving forward, everything is almost getting imbibed into technology. Even in the remotest part of Chhattisgarh, you will see people carrying mobile phone, though they are illiterates. Particularly from the non-profit's viewpoint, there are two key things that they have to consider. First thing is to have an outreach, okay, showcase their work to the outside world. The second aspect, which we have been focusing more and more on, is how they use technology internally. Moment you start using technology internally for your work, to work with your stakeholder, to work with the community that you want to bring in change, the overall efficiency of the program increases tremendously. This is a development center on the first floor, primarily various projects related to IT are being executed here. They include both for-profit and non-profit ones. This is the Bangalore Cares portal. The Bangalore Cares portal is the charity aspect of the World 10K Marathon. Mahiti provides technical infrastructure for the portal, and which includes providing facilities for online donation, volunteer recruitment, and non-profits enrollment, and non-profits managing their volunteer and donation portfolios.
You mentioned to me that you subsidize services. By what percentage do you normally, you know, subsidize your services?
See, it depends from non-profit to non-profit. For an organization of blind people who wanted to enable Hindi text-to-speech, so that using a screen reader, their community people could make use of the computers. We wrote a e-speak engine to read Hindi text and read it out in as voice.
And that would have been the first of its kind, right?
Yeah.
For Hindi.
For Hindi in a free this thing. There are commercial alternatives which cost.
So this is open source.
Oh, this is completely open source.
And is open source like a characteristic of a lot of what you develop here?
We proactively engage in open source this thing. In fact, we have been instrumental in setting up of the Python user groups in India. We have helped setting up of the Open Source Alliance in Central Asia. We are part of the SOAP Europe Association and stuff like
that. And what's the connect between the work that you do, the balance between for-profit, non-profit, being, you know, a technology firm that's enabling non-profits and open source?
Open source will play a very key role in how non-profits can embrace technology. So we proactively go and tell non-profits why they have to use open source instead of proprietary this thing. How it helps them when it comes to scaling their target groups, increasing the number of beneficiaries of their programs, and how it is also ethically important for non-profits to use open source, not just because of the cost benefit, but also because of the social value that open source brings. I would like to showcase one of our very important projects to you. We call it as Our Bank.
Okay.
It's part of the stack of tools that we offer for as part of our microbanking and financial services sector. It's a fully open source software, primarily looking at how community-based microfinancial institutions can manage their portfolio of members, their savings, their loans, and their insurance.
So right now, how many organizations use Our Bank?
In the
infrastructure?
It's an open source software available freely on the net. People whom we are handholding, we have about 9 in India, about
9 organizations
in India, about 2 in Africa, 2 in Tajikistan, about 50 in Brazil, 1 in Panama, and 1 in Philippines.
Okay.
This is a team of people from FedEx in US who have come down for a month to work with us. They are all IT professionals with 15 plus years experience.
Okay.
And one of the things that they are doing is evaluating our bank software from a technical perspective and looking at what kind of documentation that we need to build so that more and more people can adopt it.
It's really impressive to see international collaboration in open source for the non-profit sector.
We have engaged with more than 3,000 organizations across the globe. And what started as a tiny project in Bangalore today has far-reaching impact in places like Panama and Brazil. When it comes to execution, the execution team does not know whether the work is for non-profit or for profit when it comes to economics. They treat both at par. There is no differential in quality and there is no differential in resource and time commitment.
A beautiful balance between for-profit and not-for-profit, capacity building through technology, international collaboration to promote open source. Amazing. Top of the class, Mahiti. Happy to have met them. Thank you for joining me on this episode.